What is going on, ladies and gents? How are you doing? Back again here with another football recap video talking about the Bayern game and the Barcelona game. So let's get started, shall we? So first thing I'm going to talk about is the Bayern game. Now, first of all, the thing about this game is that I didn't watch the Bayern game just because I was working all night, and the game, usually the Bayern games are super early in the morning, so I do my best to wake up so that I can watch the games and do a reaction video. But sometimes, you know, I just get super tired because I was super tired from working all night, so I just slept in and I just woke up like 15 minutes ago. So now I'm doing a recap of the game. And what to say about this game? Another solid performance from Bayern today. You know, Cuisance, he had a nice game. He had a great goal scored. And Borussia Dortmund today absolutely got hammered. Andre Kramaric scored 4 Gs today against Borussia Dortmund, from what I read, I think. So, hey, this was one of Borussia Dortmund's worst performances ever. But on the other hand, for Bayern, hey, Bayern once again continued to impress, even though, you know, we're playing in a small, well, I mean, the Bundesliga is not a small league. But, you know, I know some people say it's not really as competitive as the other leagues are. But, hey, today, the way how Bayern played was absolutely incredible. Just another consistent performance. And, you know, Bayern, they won the Bundesliga. But the real question right now is, how can we play against Chelsea in the second leg of the Champions League? Because what we really want to win here is the Champions League. Because, yes, Bayern did win another Bundesliga title. But, honestly, it doesn't really excite me that much anymore, as much as winning a Champions League excites me, because Bayern have been winning so many Bundesliga titles recently that, hey, you know, it's just kind of getting old seeing them just win a Bundesliga title and not have a Champions League title to show for it. Because the real question is, how can we fare off against the other European clubs? Because I want to win the Champions League, okay? I don't know about you people, but it's been 7 freaking years since we won the Champions League, okay? And I feel like that we could have won way more Champions League titles after our 2013 campaign, okay? It's just there's a string of events that happened to Bayern, you know, during those years that prevented us from winning another Champions League title, which I'm not going to mention in this video here. But all I'm going to say is this. We are still overdue for a Champions League title, okay? We should be more than good enough right now to win the Champions League. I mean, come on, no more excuses. I'm sick and tired of making excuses for this team as to why we couldn't win a Champions League title. It's like, Bayern, just freaking do it. Don't make any excuses. Just go out there and perform against those clubs like how you perform in the Bundesliga. So as I was saying, yeah, just go out there and perform against those clubs over there. It's Chelsea, Real Madrid, Barcelona, Liverpool. Just go out there and play your best football, because that's the best type of Bayern football I want to see. You know, just us being able to compete, not just in a league like the Bundesliga, but the other clubs as well. But anyways, what else should I say about this game? There's nothing much else to say about this game except that Kingsley Coman, he had a great game. If he is very consistent for Bayern in these matches, then I feel like he's probably going to continue maintaining his starting 11 lineup until Bayern actually confirmed the arrival of Leroy Sané. Because I haven't really been paying attention to any of the Leroy Sané to Bayern Munich transfer news, because I feel like they're just spinning the narrative way too much instead of just waiting and actually confirming it. So I'm not really going to believe this thing anymore unless I actually see it, okay? Unless I actually see it. And also, one other thing I want to say is that I'm not going to believe the Thiago exit rumors, but all I'm going to say is this. Bayern should not get rid of Thiago. They should keep Thiago, because people don't realize Thiago is very, very crucial to this Bayern Munich team, okay? Thiago has been one of our best and most consistent midfielders ever since he came into Bayern, ever since, you know, he earned himself a starting chance in Bayern's starting 11. He's just been absolutely crucial for us. And us losing Thiago would be a very, very big loss for Bayern. So I would say do everything in your power to keep Thiago at Bayern, because Thiago is just, he's like a Luka Modric type slash Iniesta midfielder for Bayern. Because if we let go of him, then it's going to be very, very tough to replace him. Unless, of course, that means we're going to be making room for Havertz to come to Bayern. I would say just keep Thiago, because, I mean, if we let go of Thiago, I'm going to be pretty disappointed. Because, you know, we already made this mistake before by getting rid of Kroos, and look what happened. It worked out wonders for Real Madrid. Well, for Bayern, it didn't do anything good for Bayern, and I feel like we just really got finessed on that Toni Kroos transfer deal after the 2014 World Cup. So, yeah, that's that. I hope that Bayern learned from their mistakes, and they don't make the same mistake like how they did in the past. But anyways, that's pretty much everything here with this video, except in other news, Arjen Robben is actually coming out of retirement to play for his old club, FC Groningen, so that should be pretty, pretty exciting. And now what I'm going to talk to you people about is the Barcelona game, because I don't know where to begin with Barcelona, but Barcelona are just giving off very, very inconsistent results and performances. Because one question that I have about the Celta Vigo game is, where was Barca's defense? Because Barca's back four, I feel like, was very disorganized, and just they looked out of position in this game, and Messi single-handedly once again sees Barca from getting embarrassed by another La Liga team. And the question is, how long is Messi actually going to be able to stay at Barcelona again? Because I give Messi at max 2 years before he's actually going to leave Barcelona. Because I hate to say it, the time could be coming soon that Messi could be leaving Barcelona. And of course, you know, that's going to be the saddest day in football history, because Messi has given off everything for Barcelona. He's won nearly every trophy in the book with Barcelona. And seeing Messi leave Barcelona would just be absolutely shocking, even though, you know, it's definitely going to happen soon, if not sooner. I'm not going to say it, but I just don't understand what's going on with Barcelona. Like, do they even have a plan once Messi officially leaves the club? That's my biggest question for Barca, is what's your plan once Messi officially leaves the club? And in this game against Celta Vigo, that free kick by Iago Aspas was very well taken. But that defending right there by Barca on that free kick was absolutely sloppy, and just the worst free kick defending I have ever freaking seen. Because I feel like that the only good player on Barcelona's defense is Ter Stegen at this point, because Ter Stegen single-handedly is bailing Barcelona out nearly every game. And I just think that Barcelona, they need to work on having a better back four to start things off, because Barca's back four is just looking very, very sloppy, and I just don't see how Barca's back four is going to be able to handle playing against the other clubs in the Champions League. You know, that's my biggest question for this Barcelona team, because, I mean, this, let's be honest here, this was a game that Barcelona should have won, but Barca, they just gave away another game, and they dropped points, obviously, even though they won 1 point. Don't be surprised if Real Madrid managed to win the La Liga title, you know. And anyways, ladies and gents, that's pretty much it here with the video, because I have nothing much else to say about Barca, except that Barca is just that team again that is just giving a very inconsistent and sloppy result, and it could doom them in the Champions League if they don't make any changes. But anyways, hope you people enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, and y'all have a good one.